Good afternoon. I wish I was here in front of you today to simply wish you a happy new year and to celebrate the promise of a brighter tomorrow. But instead, I'm here for a far more solemn reason. COVID-19 is surging throughout our state, our region, and our city. We are seeing more positive cases than any time previous during this pandemic. Over 1,400 San Diegans are dead. Our hospitals are and even some of our morgues are reaching capacity. This week, the state of California extended its regional stay-at-home order for the Southern California region because of the dire trends we are seeing in ICU capacity. We know that this virus is aggressive, yet we see some irresponsible individuals have scoffed at inconvenient yet easy steps to protect themselves and all those around them. In the spring, we saw San Diegans come together to do the right thing and flatten the curve. Through the summer, and more recently, the city relied on the hope that people would do the right thing to stop the spread. But unfortunately, hope is not a strategy. And we know our overall public health suffers when leaders fail to articulate and implement a clear strategy. We've seen this in our city, and we've seen this across the nation. Therefore, I'm announcing that we will be taking meaningful action today to stop further needless deaths in our city and region. As mayor, I cannot sit idly by as our local hospitals and morgues threaten to overflow as the coronavirus surges unchecked throughout our region. So today I have signed an executive order directing stronger enforcement of the COVID-19 local and state public health orders. I've ordered the San Diego Police Department and asked the city attorney to pursue fines and potentially other enforcement actions against public nuisances who choose to endanger the lives of others and blatantly and egregiously defy the provisions of state and county public health orders. In addition, my executive order suspends parking enforcement throughout the city in an effort to encourage San Diegans to abide by the stay-at-home order. Our enforcement activities are being coordinated with our county and state partners and will go into effect at 11:59 tonight. I also want to take this opportunity to remind San Diegans that per the state's supplemental order, restrictions on non-essential activities are still in effect from 10 p.m. to 5 a.m. Now, this doesn't apply to you if you need to go to work as an essential worker, go to the grocery store, or walk your dog, but it does mean that all non-essential retail activities must cease between 10 p.m. and 5 a.m. Further, it is still required that every San Diegan wear a mask when you leave your home. This executive order is not designed to further punish those who have consistently done the right thing. This executive order is to hold accountable those who are responsible for prolonging this pandemic with their selfishness. While many have sacrificed their social lives for a greater good, others have treated this with a sickening level of apathy as their neighbors died. As much as all of us want to celebrate the end of this terrible year with our family and friends, it is more important than ever to heed the guidance of public health officials at all levels and take the necessary precautions against the spread of COVID-19. We owe it to the overburdened healthcare workers, all those suffering from economic hardships, and the families who lost their loved ones to this virus to do everything in our power to stop this devastation from dragging on any longer than it must. This is not a joke. This is a matter of life or death. I understand that many workers and small businesses are struggling, and I will be working hard with business community leaders to ensure that we invest heavily in a meaningful and equitable economic recovery. As we see the light at the end of the tunnel with vaccinations, we know that there is much to be hopeful for. But for now, the city of San Diego is sending a very clear message with our actions today that we must take this seriously and protect each other, our hospitals, and our healthcare workers. Over this past year, all of us have seen how the coronavirus has upended our lives. Too many have fallen ill, too many have lost income, and far too many were forced to sit on the sidelines while our friends or our family members died alone. So I implore you, San Diego, do not go out and gather this New Year's Eve. Stay home. Celebrate on Zoom. Cheer out your window at midnight. And next year, if we all do our part, we can gather again and be able to truly celebrate the end of this dark period in our history. Thank you.